Have you ever thought, man, my old Christmas tree is boring. I wish it shot lightning bolts. Grab some warm apple cider, cozy up next to the fire, and sit back and watch, because that's exactly what we're gonna do. We're gonna turn a Tesla coil into a Christmas tree. I have no idea if this is gonna work. Also stick around, because after that we're gonna open up some special high voltage gifts. Alright, now I can't just take one of these, shove it on top of a Tesla coil, and call it good. That ain't gonna work. This is a bunch of plastic and stuff. If you put high voltage through this, it's just gonna burn. Can't use a real tree either because it's wood. And what's wood gonna do? Well, we want something that's all metal so that it's nice and electrically conductive. So if we go on the old internet and look up DIY metal Christmas tree. Oh hey, this looks pretty cool. Let's try to make one of these. So what we need to make this, some metal wire and some kind of rod for the center. Need it to be electrically conductive though, so metal tube. And since it's a bit big for the bolt coming up through the middle, 3D printed this little adapter to make it stand up straight. But what we do is just wrap it around the pole. Then when we want to make a branch, come out, double back, and just repeat that everywhere you want a branch. And then take each one of these, chuck it in the drill. I think this came out great. Thanks to Kathy on Scratch and Stitch for the guide on how to make these. If you want to make one of these for yourself, you can find the link to the guide in the description down below. Okay, now the question is, will my Tesla coil be okay with this? Adding all of this on top of it is really gonna throw the resonant frequency off. But it's a single resonant solid state Tesla coil with secondary feedback, so it should just tune itself to whatever the resonant frequency is. I'm gonna be real pissed if this blows up my transistors. That's really cool. It's a Christmas tree that shoots lightning bolts. No Christmas tree is complete without some ornaments, though. Well now, that's a Tesla coil Christmas tree if I've ever seen one. I'd say that worked out great. So now that we have our Christmas tree, it's time to open up some gifts. Let's see, what do we have here? Ooh, this is a heavy one. Ooh, this is really cool. This is what's known as a 7704 QBL5-4000 transmitting tetrode. And if you don't understand what any of that means, that's fine. I barely do either. Basically, this is a really big, really high power vacuum tube from the 1960s. You remember the vacuum tube Tesla coil that I made with the 833A tube? Well, that tube can handle roughly about 800 watts of power. This tube, on the other hand, can handle 5,000 watts. Plan for this thing is to build a big vacuum tube Tesla coil around it. If you've read the comments on some of the other videos, or you follow me on social media, yes, I know, I've been saying that we're gonna build this coil for a while now. That build is coming. Soon. I promise. Alright, let's open the next one. This one's a bit lighter. Oh, this paper doesn't want to rip. Ugh. Oh, look. It's another vacuum tube. This is an iMac 4-250A radial beam power tetrode. If you don't know what that means either, don't worry, I'm right there with you. This has pretty similar ratings to the 833A tube. It can handle about 800 to 1000 watts. The plan for this tube is to use it to make what's called a high frequency vacuum tube Tesla coil, or plasma flame generator. Basically, you can make something that looks like a candle flame, but it's powered entirely with electricity. That's some real sorcery right there. I'm real excited to try this. On to the next gift. A bit smaller. This is vacuum grease, also known as the forbidden toothpaste. Seriously though, don't brush your teeth with vacuum grease. Okay, but what the hell is vacuum grease? Well, remember the Fuser video? And how it didn't work? The main problem is that my vacuum chamber is definitely leaking. This vacuum grease, applied around the seals, along with some other improvements that I'm planning to make, hopefully will seal up all the leaks, and it'll actually work this time. So yes, we are planning on getting back to that project. And there actually is one more gift, and you're looking through it right now. We've got a new camera, Canon EOS R6. That means we can shoot in 4K, not just 1080. And what's even more cool is we can shoot in C-Log or C-Log 3 to get even more dynamic range. And if you have no idea what that means, seems to be a recurring theme here, that's fine. I hardly understand it either. Basically, it means we can get way more vibrant colors, especially when there are big differences between the dark parts and the light parts in the video, and we'll get less noise in the dark parts of the video. I think this is really cool for a lot of the stuff that we film on this channel. A lot of times we're looking at really bright things like Tesla coil arcs or these plasma tube discharges, but then they're in really dark environments with the lights and everything turned way down so we can see them. Let me tell you, it's an adventure learning how to edit log footage though when you're not a professional like me, because before you apply the color grading and post-processing, it looks like this. Which, as you can see, isn't actually what it looks like in real life. So that's fun. But hopefully it'll let you see how amazing some of these things look in real life. Anyway, Coilers, Merry Christmas and Happy Holidays to you for whatever you may celebrate. I really appreciate every single one of you being here, and I hope you stick with me because we've got a lot more crazy stuff to build coming up. In the meantime though, you should go check out some of the other crazy stuff that we've built already.